And it is the men round, and I am supporting the same topic which I supported earlier. And it is the same that men, the women are humanitarian, they are the helpers, they are the most merciful than men. And my first point is that the New Zealand's Prime Minister, woman Prime Minister, Jacinda Ardern, on Christchurch attack, she said that she was greeted with a standing ovation. Standing ovation means that she was awarded a standing ovation because she on the Christchurch attack there were 54 people were killed, and they were all Muslims. They were all killed in mosques, and during that worship they were killed. They were killed by only one Australian people, and he was from Australia. So how can you believe that the men are humanitarian? They are the helper. So this is the perfect example. The example I gave you right now is the best example to explain that point that the women are the humanitarians. And my second point is that the Pakistan Prime Minister Benazir Bhutto was a fighting leader, and she was selected as the 7 members of United Nations to be given the Nobel Prize. But due to the interference of the people like people who were hating them, they killed them in the Rawalpindi martyrdom because the people hated them because she wanted to solve the problems of the country. But people who were the opponent, who were her opponent, they didn't want to happen that. They wanted this welfare of the country. So they killed her at the martyrdom of Rawalpindi. This is the best, one of the best examples to explain that point. And everybody of you sitting here, and as the audience will be watching the dramas, will be watching the TV programs and everything. So I want to give you an example that explains that the women are the humanitarians, they are the helper, they are the soft nature. Mohsin Abbas, he was a Pakistani, he is a Pakistani actor, and he beat his wife Fatima Naqvi. And I want to show you the picture of the Mohsin Abbas. This is Mohsin Abbas, and this is his wife. And this is this, oh, and he beat God. And he beat his wife just like that. And you can show this picture because you can see this picture as an evidence. And the second example I have brought here is the APS attack of Peshawar. And APS attack of Peshawar, I think that more than 150 students were killed. They were all innocent. They were all. We can say that the innocent people, because innocent students, because they didn't do anything. The terrorists came and they attacked them, and this is the reason why the APS attack Peshawar is still in the hearts of people, the heart and soul of the people. Yes. And people are don't forget the efforts which the APS Peshawar made for their students. And this is, I think, the worst ever incident happened in Pakistan in a school or college. 154 students were killed. Can you imagine in the summer court, if 154 students are killed, how will this be? How will this incident and tragedy be for you? Because you will be burning candles, because you will be crying, and you will be doing some, we can say that, you will not bear that atmosphere of Umarkot if 154 students will be killed. So this was the condition of the people of Peshawar when 154 students were killed. And I want to show the picture of a few of them, this picture. I think that this picture will make everyone cry, because this picture is inspirational. This picture is, we can say, the terrorist victim. These students were the terrorist victim, and they had to suffer the wrath of the terrorists, and that those terrorists were none other than men. So in this incident, we can justify that, we can prove that the men are, women are the humanitarians, they are the helper, they are everything for building the society. So Lady Diana, she was a princess of Wales. Wales is called the part of British by which England and Wales are connected. So this was a country. She was the princess of Wales, and Lady Diana was killed in honor killing by men. Can you imagine that the princess or the prime minister, just like Benazir Bhutto, being killed in front of a huge crowd, in front of a whole crowd in Rawalpindi? So this same incident happened there, in honor killing. A man came there and he killed Lady Diana, one of the important personalities of England, of British, of all the world at that time. And this tragedy made every Britishers cry, because she was Lady Diana. She was a lady, and she was killed very mercilessly. And the sixth example I want to give it to you, that the acid throwing victim. You know that in our society there are many cases of acid throwing, but the acid throwing doesn't mean that we just throw the acid. It is called acid throwing. The acid throwing is called when any man carries an acid and throws it to the woman, and the whole the face of the woman gets spoiled.
Thank you. Wonderful.